find this? Is it a video?
Just Craigslist, yeah.
So my mom and I bought some land in Washington State, out in the countryside, and to build on it, we want to have a bit of infrastructure there, you know, like a place to live. We looked at buying a new RV, and it just seemed kind of not as fun as finding something like this.
So what do you think, Mom?
And fixing it up.
Amazing.
And just looking at the chassis, you can see there's a lot of work to do.
I think you can tell by looking at it that it's a total gut job. Nothing is salvageable in here.
I'm holding my breath.
It all smells really mildewy and rotten.
Wow, that's just like an open.
I think it's amazing that this thing is over 70 years old, and this is probably the first time it's moving in years.
So the guy who sold this to us, he and his dad run a tow truck company, and it seems like a little scrapyard there. And supposedly his dad has had this for 10 or 15 years and originally wanted to scrap it. But he thought that this had some value to it and wanted to save it and sell it. But not sure why they held on to it for so long.
Partway through and looking a bit better already.
Woo. So the shell of the trailer was made in 1949, but I highly doubt that this interior is original.
Overall, my mom and I were there at the scrapyard for about 7 hours. I'd say probably 5 hours of that we were actually actively scrapping the inside.
It's a godsend to have to be able to take it apart here.
I know. I never would have been able to do it in my backyard.
No.
There's just all these things lining up.
Nice. Roll down windows.
Yeah, gum.
You can see just how dusty all that is, so of course, always wear a good mask when doing anything like this. Another good tip, drink lots of water. I did not bring enough water, and by the end of this, I was getting close to some kind of heat stroke symptoms. My arms were cramping up, and I just could not use my hands anymore. That my fingers, like my thumb, would clamp down to my palm. I just had to immediately try and pull my finger back with the other hand. Not fun.
You can see all the trash that came out of there. That was a lot of work. There goes the Spartan.
I was really worried about this step in the process, backing this thing into my backyard, because as you can see, it's pretty tight. There's my neighbor's fence there, and you can't see yet, but there's a telephone pole in my other neighbor's house on the other side, and this guy just backed it in so proficiently. It was amazing. As soon as it was in the backyard, I was really excited to start making some progress on it. And there was still a very musty, mildewy smell inside, so I wanted to try and vacuum out anything that could still be holding on to that and get rid of any wood and other porous materials that were in there.
I need to figure out where all these ants are living and finding all this food. I got all the screws out. Let's see what. And I don't know where the handle is, but nothing happening right now. So I'm guessing it could have something to do with all that rust there. So there are a ton of these all over the place. So I'm gonna get the grinder
and try and get a lot of them out, so it's a little easier to walk in here.
Some of the screws that weren't overly rusty, I was able to just unscrew rather than cutting them out with the grinder.
Most of the screws out. Should make it a lot easier to walk there now.
There are so many random connectors and bits sticking out after having removed all the interior, so just showing some of the different things that you had to remove.
After a while, you have a bit of a record of all the rivets you've undone. Still trying to get rid of anything with wood. And so this looks like it was a vent at one point, but yeah, obviously it's just blocked up with wood now for whatever reason. So after getting the screws out behind this. All right. Looks like there's one more. Yeah. Yeah, so this is where we want to get rid of all this kind of stuff. There's also stuff like this on here. Maybe just to hold a flag or an antenna. Bye bye. Kind of sad having these big holes in the side of this thing, but we'll fix those all up at some point. And then pulling out the old wiring. I think a lot of this is for the brakes and stuff, the brake lights. One is being towed. Thanks for watching. I hope that this video was useful or informative in some way, even if it's a warning story not to take on a project like this. Sometimes I have my doubts about it. I'll be putting out other videos as I work through this refit project, and I hope you'll tune in to watch those as well. Thanks! Looking a lot better with just a little wash.